Yo, I have a 2012 Honda Pilot in here. This thing's growling going down the freeway a little bit. The wheel bearings are tight, they don't move at all. But if I put my hand on this coil spring, you can barely hear it, but I can feel it. The noise from this wheel bearing is resonating up the coil spring, and the other side doesn't do that. So I know this bearing's noisy, and I'm just gonna go ahead and attack that. There's the Chinese part number I have for this. 22 millimeter on these lug nuts. I have a couple of number 3 Phillips screws on the rotor. I'm gonna use an impact screwdriver to get these off. If they don't come off, you can drill them out or like use a chisel or an air hammer and a chisel if you want. The head on that snapped off. Oh, these are really rusted, stuck on here. Well, those didn't like to come off. I want to unload this caliper a little bit. You could try to take a C-clamp and put it on the inside of the brake pad on this side and over here just to pull it in. I'm going to use a regular screwdriver. There's a lot of pad left on here. This is the actual brake pad. Here's the backing, the metal backing for it. And then I want to get on the inside of this rotor where the rotor vanes are in this hole. And I just want to pull it back ever so gently. Nice and slow. And that way this caliper is going to be unloaded. It should move really nice. If none of this stuff moves, you got other issues with your brakes you need to take care of. So that's fine. I have a bungee cord here I'm going to use to hang this caliper, because I don't want any weight on this brake hose, because this caliper with the whole assembly, it is quite heavy. These are 19 millimeter bolts on the caliper support bracket. I'm just going to take this off in a whole assembly and bungee cord the thing up. This rotor should just fall right off. I got lucky in this state, they're usually rusted on really good. And if they are, you want to get a really big hammer and you just want to hit on the edge of the hat in a circle really hard until it busts free. That's usually the best way to get these off. This center nut is a 36 millimeter. Oh really? It's not coming off for me. I couldn't get this thing off with an impact, so I just put a couple of lug nuts on it and put the tire on. And since the rotor's not on here either, you don't want to get it tight or anything. I just kind of screwed them down finger tight, and I put the whole car on the ground so I can try to get this off by hand. Oh my God, is that tight. I gotta get a little jack pull action on here for some leverage. I just broke my snap-on breaker bar. I'm gonna use the entire jack pull. See if I can break a snap-on shorty ratchet. Wow, I just destroyed the guts in this ratchet. Now what do? I got some 3/4 inch breaker bar Chinese junk I'm gonna try. Give this a whirl. See if I can wreck this. Ooh, I'm getting it! Okay, I just wanna make sure this axle goes in. It's kinda stucky a little. I'm gonna put a little lube in here. There, it's in all the way. Now I have 4 17 millimeter bolts on this wheel bearing. I'm just gonna get them off with an impact and a swivel socket, hopefully. I just turned the wheel to get good access to these. Now I straighten the wheel back out so the axle's straight with the wheel bearing, so it's easier to get on and off. And I'm just gonna ever so gracefully whack this with a sledgehammer until it breaks free and comes off. And it's really stuck. keep on a whacking. That sucker's not budging. Break time. I have no faith in these slide hammers. This is one good way to kill your elbows and your arms too, because once it hits here, man, it if you're really pulling on these, it can really hurt your arms. I'm gonna give it a few whacks on. I'm gonna just see if it'll wanna budge. I can tell it did move a little bit because there's a little gap in between the backing plate for me whacking it with a sledgehammer, so I'm just gonna keep at it. Unbelievable. A few more whacks and this hub's gonna come right out, and I don't know what to do. I'm gonna try to stick an air hammer in between the bearing and the backing plate. Well, enough of that noise. I'm not getting that off of there. I quit. I'm gonna have to use a press. So I gotta take this steering knuckle off. If you live in the Rust Belt like I do, you might not ever get one of these off by hand like this. 10 millimeters. I'm gonna take this ABS wire with me because if I try to unbolt it from the knuckle, it's just gonna break because I live in the Rust Belt. There's no way that thing's coming out of the knuckle. Follow the ABS wire and you'll find the plug. Just gonna get in here with a tool and pry this thing out. Unplug it. I'm gonna take off this outer tie rod next. There's a cheesy old rusty cotter pin on here. Just gonna take this out with a side cutters. 17 millimeter on this. I don't like wrecking these boots with pickle forks, and you can't use one of them ball joint removers for these either, because it'll crush the four holes for the cotter pin. So I'm just gonna whack this knuckle with a hammer until this thing falls out. I have a lower ball joint. There's no cotter pin in this. This has got one of those. Should be a 19 millimeter on this. I gotta get this off with a wrench. Same deal here. I'm just gonna try to whack it a few times with a hammer and hopefully it'll break free. I wanna put this back on exactly the same way as it came off, or the steering angles are gonna be off and it's gonna need an alignment. So I'm just gonna make a mark right here for the knuckle and the strut on both sides to make darn sure I get this put back. These are 24 millimeters. Let's see if I can break another snap-on ratchet. I've never broke more than two in a row in a day. Oh, I should be able to push this axle through. I'm gonna hit this with a bunch of penetrant. Hopefully it'll soak up really good. I'll let it soak for an hour or two. Well, if the wheel bearing treats you that bad, I guess you gotta use a hub tamer on it, or just give up and take the knuckle to a mechanic shop and say, here, get this thing off for me. I'm gonna bend the backing plate a little bit, but yeah, it's just a backing plate. I'll be able to work with it. No way. I don't think it's moving. There is no way that should not be coming up right now. I'm gonna have to put this whole unit in the press, persuade it some more. Well, there it is. I put the whole unit in the press. I'm sure if you watch somebody else do a video on this, there's probably some southern guy in a Honda dealership that just takes one right out. Let's see if I can break a tool doing this. This thing, there's no reason why this thing shouldn't just come right out. There it goes. Oh my God, is this thing ridiculously tight? That was a little unbelievable. I don't think your backyard tree jacker is going to be getting that thing off. Seriously, Honda, you got a little carried away with the depth and the tightness of this thing. I kind of wrecked the holes and things in this backing plate a little bit. Oh, it goes this way. Who knew? I'm going to get in here with a punch and try to round these holes out again. I should really get a new backing plate. And then again, not really. A little blacksmith and I'll fix it right up. What did I do? Nothing a little spanking can't fix. I'm gonna get in here with a little wire wheel action and do a little de-rusting. That wire wheel was a little bit impractical. I'm gonna get in here with a whizzer wheel. I need actual sandpaper. That's some thick rust in there. Kind of boogered up a hole a little bit. Kind of almost a 3164. Give it a little draw file action. Okay. Do the muffed up backing plate. Do the Chinese wheel bearing. Ooh, it went in the hole. Ooh. These hub bolts get torqued to 72 foot-pounds. I just went in a circle and torqued them down a bunch just to make sure everything squished really good. This looks special. I don't know how that's supposed to look, but it'll work like that. I'm just gonna put this junk back together. First thing I'm gonna do is put this lower ball joint in. I'll just start the castle nut for right now. I'm gonna stick this in the hole. Line up the splines. Ooh, that went in like it was supposed to. Line up these strut bolts. I'm just gonna stick a punch in one of the holes. There's only a little bit of movement here, but that'll actually change your alignment angle quite a bit. So I gotta make sure that's lined up right. Yeah, it's like if I just let it fall, it's lined up. These strut mounts get torqued to 156 foot-pounds, and you wanna use the torque wrench on the nut side. Put this wire back on. 8 foot-pounds if you care about these. This outer tie rod gets tightened to 45 foot-pounds. And it's just spinning. Put a little weight on the bottom of the ball and they usually tighten right up. I'll put a new cotter pin on here. This lower ball joint you want to tighten to 80 foot-pounds. And you're never going to get a torque wrench under here, I don't think. Just gonna guess. Put my little wiry clippy thing back in there. Now I'm gonna put this rotor on. I'm gonna screw it on best as I can. I'm just gonna use one screw because that's all I have. If you live in the rust belt, you're gonna want to make sure there's no rust on the back of this hat. It's got to be nice and clean. Then really when it's on, I just got to make sure this backing plate isn't touching anything. It looks great. Get my bungee cord off of here. Gonna make sure I don't twist up this brake line and put this back on. These caliper support brackets get tightened to 101 foot-pounds. double check everything again, spin the rotor, make sure the backing plate's not hitting, make sure the caliper moves really nice. I'm gonna start this nut, get this tire on here. 94 foot-pounds on these lug nuts. Anytime you put a hub on one of these two, you want to recheck these lug nuts after about 50 or 100 miles just to make sure these studs were pressed all the way in on this. And I'm going to let this thing on the ground. I'm going to torque that nut. 242 foot-pounds on this nut. Which is a heck of a lot. Now there's a little notch right here in the axle that you pound in to make sure this nut doesn't back off. You can take the tire off and do it, but I'm just going to get in here with an air hammer. Hammer it down a little bit. That'll be fine. Now I'm just going to go drive it for 50 miles and check the lug nuts. I'll pick up the victim. Okay, bye.